I want to show you a really fun video and technique on how to get your dog to do what's called a focused heel. This is not heeling like regular pet dog heeling. This is more for competition, and it's called a focused heel because the dog is really looking at you very unnaturally. And to do that, it's a really conditioned behavior. It's a conditioned habit that we train a dog to do. And I'm going to show you a little bit of that with the Dwayne-O-Mator. Dwayne, come here. Good boy. And all I'm really going to cover in this topic or in this video is the focus heel. It's how to get the dog's head to come up and how to get the dog to walk next to you. So I'm going to show it to you first with a real green dog like Dwayne, who knows just a little bit of it. And then I'm going to show you the technique with Goofy, who's a finished dog. So the first thing you want to do is you want to get your dog into this heel position, right, where he's next to you. And again, this is all going to be done with toys or treats. So with the treat, I keep the treat right here at my hip and I get the dog to look at it. And when he looks at it, I can release and go, yeah, there he's a good boy. Here again, I'm gonna hold the treat right here, get his focus. He's not allowed to jump up at it. If he does, I just kind of hold it here. And when he looks at it, yes, good boy. I give him the treat. Every time, I'm gonna keep a couple extra treats here. When I get him into heel position, heel, and I'm gonna touch on the heel position here for a second. He's got to be next to you. So his feet have to be at your foot. In German, we say Fuß because his feet are on my feet and Fuß means foot. In this position, he can't move from here. So before you start any walking, the natural tendency is going to be to have the dog here and say heel and take off. And the dog's going to start looking down and looking up and looking down and looking up. And that's not what you're looking for. What you're looking for right now is a dog that will get into this position and hold this position while I start with a little walking in place, right? Good. Good. Yeah, good boy. And what I might even do with him here is do this walking in place and then yes, and throw the treat to the left side, because what I don't want the dog to do is to crowd into me and start getting in front of my feet. So Dwayne, heel, he's in position. I take the treat up. Now in theory, in an AKC type heeling, this hand is going to be in front of my belly. So he's going to go here. I'm going to say, hey, Dwayne, good, good. Hey, good boy. Look, look, good, good. Yes. And I'm going to release him there. I try not to make the habit of releasing the dog to this treat every time, because if I do, he's going to get pushy for this. Sometimes the treat might come from my mouth. Sometimes the treat might come from the side. It might get thrown to the side. It's all going to depend what I see the dog doing. So you're going to need to watch your dog on this or get a really good coach to help you along with this. But the basic things of learning, the basic structure of it, is what we're going to talk about here. So the dog's in heel position. I have my hand in what we call AKC heel position, which is here, and the dog is heeling and he's in perfect position. I'm walking in place. This is the first place where this is going to fall apart, because the dog is going to start to look at my feet or start looking around. As long as he's looking at me, yes, I'm going to reward that. And really important, this is the most critical part of this technique, is reward your dog before he looks away. The natural habit here is going to be, Dwayne, to get the dog in position and do this heel, 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 and then he's going to look down, and then you're going to yank him up, and he's going to look down, you're going to yank the leash up and say, hey, no, 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 yes. Because you're starting to teach the dog that looking back at you is the reward, not the continuation of the look. That's the most critical thing, and it's a mistake I made early on in my training. I fixed it, so I really want to harp on it here for a second. The dog is getting rewarded for the continuation of looking at you, not for looking down and up and down and up and down and up. And that's something you'll see with a lot of dogs that aren't properly trained, that they'll start walking perfectly, then they'll look down, then they'll look up, then they'll look down, then they'll look up, because they've been conditioned to get rewarded for looking back at the person, not for continuing the look. The way we reward the continuation of the look is we break the look from our side. So Dwayne, come on. So if I'm here and I've got a really nice focus on Dwayne, heel, good, good, he's looking, he's looking, he's looking, he's looking. Yeah, good boy. I end it before he ends it. That's critical. That teaches him that I'm going to keep looking because there's a reward coming, and I'm never going to look away until he tells me to look away. Because the only way to fix the look away is not going to be to lure him back with a positive, but to break the looking away with a negative, which is going to be a pop up on this leash. And you want to do that as little as possible. Of course you're going to correct the dog. If he looks away, you'll see, I'll do it with Dwayne. We'll give him some pops up to get him to look. But it's an aversive that makes the heel a tiny bit sloppier, where it can be a lot neater through continuous positive motion. It's absolutely impossible to do it 100% positive. I'm going to give you that one. You're going to need to give the dog a pop on a leash, and it's not going to kill him, it's not going to hurt him, it's not going to break his spirit. But it's going to be something you want to do as little as possible, right? You want to put corrections in where they're necessary, not where you don't need them. So I've got a treat here. What I'm going to do now for the first time is I'm going to walk him a little bit. So I'm going to take a few steps and watch how short I keep these steps. I go, good boy, good heel. Heel. Good, now he's going there. So now I'm gonna tell him, let's go. He's looking, looking, looking. Yeah, good boy. I make that a major event, right? So he's like, holy cow, what happened? I just was looking at you and suddenly you exploded with dynamic energy. That's what you want your dog to see. That dynamic energy dials him in. Come on, Dwayne, heel. Because training is kind of boring unless you make it exciting. Heel, let's go. Left foot, good, 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 good. Yeah, good boy. And you, in the beginning, want to encourage your dog to continue that look, which I use a bridge word like good. Heel, that's my command. Good, this is my bridge. Let's go. Good, good. Let's try to make a turn. So come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Good, good boy. I'll make the turn again. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. He's still looking up. And I stop. Yeah, good boy. And he's got perfect focus. I'm gonna come towards the camera on this one so you can see the focus again. See, he starts to fade out. Dwayne, Dwayne. Keep your excitement level high so you don't need as many corrections. Don't feel afraid to correct him if you need to, but try not to do more corrections than are needed. Good boy, Dwayne. Ready? Let's go. Look at the focus, look at the focus, look at the focus. Yes. And be sure that you don't each and every time do it the same. That you don't each and every time stop, sit, look, then reward. Or reward him in the middle. You're going to mix this up because you don't want the dog expecting any one thing. You want the dog, hey, fooey, to be ready for anything and to be super excited throughout that technique.